We're intelligent people, right? We're not paranoid, but we are deliberate in our choices. And to choose well, we have to be informed. You've probably heard about non-browning apples by now, brought to you by Arctic Apples, just like this video. Most people support the idea of reducing food waste. It's kind of a no-brainer. And we all support healthier eating for our kids, and a lot of us just really love apples. All of that is good, but if you're like me, and you're someone who's trying to feed your kids the best foods possible, then it makes sense that we would want to know more about how this non-browning stuff all works. Okay, first off, we have to start with DNA. If you didn't see my video where I used Lego to communicate how DNA works, I'm gonna do it again. Here's a short and easy recap. DNA for any living thing is like an instruction book for a Lego set where the bricks are proteins. In the DNA instructions between like the cover page and that last page where you see all the Lego parts, all that stuff in between are the genes. The genes are the parts of your DNA that has the instructions to build you, or a plant, or any other living thing. Those instructions say which protein brick should go where to create the model the instructions asked for. In the case of our DNA, it's the instructions to build like each of us. And the tiny differences in our DNA instruction books are what make us all unique individuals, each with tiny differences in how our proteins assemble. So it's like two people are two Lego models. The slight difference in their DNA is represented by the two separate unique instruction booklets required to build each individual person from the bricks of proteins. Those small differences in the instructions lead to one set of bricks becoming like a blue jay and one set of bricks becoming like a robin. And even though both models are kind of built of the same parts, they're just arranged in different ways. Okay, so DNA, we got that, right? All right, now to explain how this non-browning apple works, we only need to know about one more thing, really: RNA. Without RNA, your DNA is just a molecule. Your RNA is what brings all of that to life. So if a natural apple is made of protein Legos from DNA instructions, then that Lego creation still needs a builder so that all of that protein potential can come together and bring life to any living thing. Bricks and instructions don't mean much if there's not someone or something to read the instructions and assemble the bricks. In the case of any natural thing growing in the world, it would be RNA that does the building on behalf of the DNA. So in our Lego metaphor, I'm the RNA. I read the Lego instructions and these models get put together with my own two hands. So in this metaphor, my eyes and brain are the mRNA, the messenger RNA, and my hands are a cell's ribosome. They take the bricks, the proteins, and assemble them together according to the instructions in the DNA manual. So again, in nature, we have a DNA set of instructions, and the mRNA reads the instructions and delivers them to my ribosome hands so that they can assemble the bricks of proteins into what the DNA intended. Okay. It's making sense to me. I hope you're still with me on this. So one more time, we start with DNA instructions, then the mRNA, the messenger RNA, reads them and delivers them to the ribosome hands, which assemble the proteins into a living thing. Seriously, we understand DNA way better now, right? Okay, now that we've got that basis, we're pretty close to understanding how this apple works. Back in the late 1980s, some smart Australians started wondering why one type of wild grape didn't turn brown. When they looked into it, they found that the three genes that produce an enzyme called PPO, or polyphenol oxidase, were not expressing in that variety of wild grapes. That prevented that particular wild grape from turning brown, like all the others. The genes that do that had just been like naturally turned off. When mRNA doesn't translate an instruction, that's what scientists mean when they talk about genes not being expressed. So in the case of the apple, it's like my mRNA eyes had read the DNA instructions, but for some reason I didn't use my ribosome hands to assemble the proteins into the part of the apple that makes PPO. The question is, why didn't I? The mRNA knows like something's different when it has a page that's been double printed, so it runs interference, literally RNAi or RNA interference. It's like my brain was gonna tell my hands what to build, but then it realized the page was double printed, so it just stopped. Same for those wild grapes. They saw a double page, so they didn't build the PPO enzyme. All right, wow, okay, that's kind of understandable in a complicated way, but hey, now we know about DNA, we know about RNA, mRNA, and RNAi too. I feel smarter. I think we're gonna look smarter at parties for sure. Okay, so back to the apple. It turns out that a non-browning apple is just a regular apple. But using the process we just learned about, scientists have ensured the apple had that double printed page. That's how we get an apple that doesn't turn brown. It turns out it literally could have happened in nature by accident, just like with the grape. But like, why wait for the proverbial million monkeys on a million typewriters to type Hamlet when we can just get that variety now? The non-browning apple is literally just doing what the non-browning wild grape does, just not expressing those PPO genes. This whole thing is turning out to be very unscary. I mean, we're not actually asking nature to do anything that it doesn't do anyways. And we understand about food waste, and we know it's important to get kids to eat less candy and more fruit. So some smart people observed nature. They figured out how it could do some cool things, and then they took those lessons and applied them to the apples. Well, I mean, there we have it. Now we all know why they keep telling us these non-browning apples are healthy. It's because they're regular freaking apples. Okay, we had to do like a lot of reading to understand all of this, but I'd like to thank the team of scientists over at Arctic Apples for helping us to make sure we didn't misrepresent their work and helping us get the science right. They're pretty proud of their work over at Arctic Apples, and I don't blame them. We'd also like to thank the many scientists who wrote the many scientific papers we had to read to make sure that we understood this topic well enough to explain it with Legos. So thanks to Arctic Apples for sponsoring this video and for giving me an opportunity to understand how this non-browning apple came to be. If you want to see this non-browning apple up close and maybe even put it in your mouth, follow the link in the description and order some like tasty apple snacks. They're really good. Also, thanks to our patrons as always, and just thanks for watching in general. We'll see you next time.